Welcome in once again to Tishomingo County Braves Football Coaches Show with head coach Jim Mckay, your host. For the Tishomingo County Braves Coaches Show is Jack Ivey.
Hello again and welcome into the Tishomingo County High School Braves Football Coaches Show. I'm Jack Ivey live here, and of course we're going to bring in Coach Jim Mckay in just a minute to talk about the big game this past Friday night with the New Albany Bulldogs. And of course we got Senatobia coming up, big road trip, and of course this season winding down, and of course the guys are getting ready to head over to Senatobia Friday night, and hopefully you'll get over to Senatobia Friday night as the Braves travel in this division here. As of course this move, we picked up some new teams, and of course this will be our first trip over to Senatobia to broadcast, but we're looking forward to that trip over Friday night. Going back to the tough loss, 48-14 was your final score Friday night against New Albany. And of course, we've talked about it week in and week out. If you turn it over too much and don't put any points on the board, you're not going to get too many wins. And Coach, this game kind of reminded me of Corinth a little bit. Let's bring in Coach. I told Coach when he came in, I said, if we could do away with the last 10 minutes of the second quarter, it'd be a whole different season. I don't know what's happening in the second quarter. We're not jinxed in the second quarter, are we, Coach?
It almost seems like it. Same thing as last week against Corinth. We just had way too many turnovers and gave them great field position, and they took advantage of it.
Of course, the ball game against New Albany, of course, week in and week out, it doesn't matter who comes to town, you're going to have a tough game when you're in this 4A division. And how did New Albany shape up with some of the other teams we've played of late?
They're very comparable to Corinth and Ripley. We thought that they were not going to be as good, and turns out they are. Have as much speed as the other two teams. Senatobia will be the same way as will Byhalia. We're just going to have to do a better job of protecting the football and blocking and tackling.
Coach, on a Friday night after a tough loss, I know it's tough losing these games, and of course you got a feeling pretty good about that homecoming win. It's always nice to win the homecoming game, but I don't know how you coaches do it, because you got to not only be a coach, but you got to have some of these other skills too to try to keep the guys up, because even though you lose on Friday night, you got to turn right around and play the next Friday night, and if you're not prepared mentally and physically, you know, it could be worse. And what do you say to a team on Friday night after a couple of big losses in a row to Corinth and New Albany?
Just, you know, keep plugging away. Again, they're still learning this offense, which has caused some problems on Friday nights. But if you love the game and love to play, then there's not much that a coach has to say to get you ready.
Of course, you know, if you're a hometown Tishomingo County Braves, win, lose, or draw, you should be there on Friday night and support the team regardless. And I know a lot of folks, as you call it in the college ranks, you're fair weather fans. And I don't know about you, but like going to college games, somebody said, surely you're not going today. They're playing so-and-so. Yeah, I'm going today and stuff. So I go win, lose, or draw. And you, as a supporter of Tishomingo County Braves football, you need to be there on Friday night regardless, win, lose, or draw, on the road, and support these teams. And, of course, I don't know anybody watching or anybody coaching or anybody playing that don't want to win every ball game, but you're just not going to win them all every year. And we're hoping down the road that we can turn this thing around, Coach.
And I think we can. You know, if we get the numbers up, you know, right now, we have a handful of seniors, and usually when you have a good football team, you have a large group of seniors, and we just hadn't had that the past few years.
Coach, this past Friday night, injuries in the ball game. Can you give us an update on both?
Yeah, it was just a regular hit on a return, and Bo breaks his ankle. Not sure how or why. I got pictures of it Friday night, and he's going to have surgery probably this morning at some point. You know, and last week we lost Kobe Tapp, our other cornerback, so we're kind of limited right now on defense as to who can play what.
So, Bo, we'll say a prayer for you and hope everything goes well. And, of course, you hate to lose a player and stuff, and that's not one of those injuries you can come back off of quickly. No. By no means going to be a long rehab, but I know Bo Oliveira will have a lot of folks praying for him as he goes to surgery. Do you know where he's going to have the surgery done?
Not sure. He went to the emergency room in Corinth Friday night, so I'm sure probably over there.
So we'll be thinking about you, Bo, and I know Bo's a big senior on this year's team and has had a really good season for the Braves. Any other injuries we need to talk about, Coach?
No, I think those are the only two right now.
I know that we needed to address that because Blake and Randall was talking about it on the game Friday night, and they said, I'm sure we'll find out all the information on the coach's show on Monday. So, Blake, you and Randall, there you go. You heard it straight from the coach, and we appreciate it. Coach, we're going to go to the highlights. It was, of course, a home game Friday night, the New Albany Bulldogs in town, and the kiddos getting to come through the new run-through, and thanks to all the folks. I don't know who all was involved in it. I know Chris Cornelison was heavily involved in this as far as supporting it, but the run-through, and I believe they kind of liked that.
I hope they did. I hope they stay playing the game, and when they get to Tishomingo County High School, they want to be a Brave.
Captains for the night as the Braves go out for the big coin toss. Once again, we're live at Tishomingo County High School, and of course, New Albany Bulldogs coming to town. Any strategy do you normally like to take the ball or not like to take the ball, or does it depend on who we're playing, or do you
Normally, if I can defer, I'll defer. If I lose, I'll take the ball just to make sure I get that extra possession.
So you did defer there to the second half?
Yes.
I saw a game earlier this year, and the team that won the toss, it was kind of a mix-up. And
chose defense?
Yeah, they said, we'll kick off or whatever. So the home team, guess what, got the ball first half and the second half. So, you know, if you got a really good defense, sometimes the here's what I wanted to show you there. And of course,
what do we expect from New Albany tonight?
Yeah, that's something that Mr. Howell started this year with the horse and the warrior, the Brave.
Ready to go there, and of course, there you see the Braves coming out of the new Braves helmet there. And I got to looking Friday night. Have we got 150 cheerleaders and pom-pom girls?
I think that's all of the middle schools came, and plus ours and our dance squad.
There was a bunch of them. I knew they had some visitors performing, of course, Friday night down at Tisch County, and I'm sure the guys liked all that extra yelling coming out and stuff. So, Coach, here we're kicking off. We're going left to right. We're kicking back toward the field house here. And here's Braves football coach, Coach Jim Mckay. Coach?
Yeah, Bo's kicking off for us with Kobe absent. Does a really good job. I think that was Tavius Duckett on that tackle. They were a lot speedier in person than they were on film.
Coach, I know you work on missed tackles and all that stuff and wrapping up, but you give them two or three extra chances.
You know, we even stressed that last week at practice. Worked on that.
Then you get the extra offsides helping. You know, most of these teams don't need any extra help, right? So, Senatobia will be coming up Friday night. I don't know how they'll compare. We'll talk about that in a minute. But New Albany doesn't waste very much time to ease down the field and take a 7-0 lead.
Pretty good return by Tavius Duckett here. I don't know why people keep kicking to him. I'm glad they do.
Oh, yeah. Then we get another penalty on the kickoff that negates that good return. I was going to check. Of course, we don't have a camera. I was checking to see if you had any hair left after Friday night. Of course, we get some yardage back here on the penalty against New Albany, so we're a little past the midfield mark.
Yeah, we added a tight end set this week, thinking it would help us with our running game, and it did to an extent.
What tight ends you got in the rotation?
Cade Butler played most of the night. Caleb Garner had a few snaps there.
Right spot on the punt there, Coach.
Yeah, pinned him back.
Good job stringing that one out. And when he cuts back, Breeze make a good tackle. That is number 22 for New Albany, Jordan Lipsy. And he has brought down a big tackle for shotgun formation, standing inside the end zone. Three on the play clock now. I think New Albany's going to call a timeout. Of course, they tried to draw us off sides there. And number two, Reno Montgomery back in the game. And he tried a wide out pass, and it is complete. Wow, what a play. And that was an eligible pass. Just kind of got caught in no man's land right there. They had a run pass option. Did a really good job of it. Pass set up and it's complete to Reno Montgomery. He's very shifty, but Tavius Stuckett will bring him down. Shy of the first down. The high squad, he had a reasonable price, 662-423-3203. There's a fumble on that play on the pitch. And the Braves have Montgomery tripped up and finally brought down at the final time. So a loss of 16 yards on the play. Brings up third and long, and they're just going to look for that wide receiver right or running back pass again. And what a lick there! Yes, even though they picked up the first down on that. Good series here,
right,
Coach.
Force them into punting.
Here's the punt. Looks like Tavius Stuckett's going to let this one fall to the turf, and it will roll inside the 40.
Randall should have picked that one up and run it back. Shouldn't he? Copy of tonight's game is available on DVD. Contact Jack or Denise, Ivy 662-454-9797 as the Braves begin their second drive. If you just tuned in, you're watching Tishomingo County High School Braves Football Coaches Show. Jack Ivey along with Coach Jim Mckay. And cut it back towards the middle of the field, and he will have first down yardage and then some. Click the TCH Sports Link. You can listen to us from anywhere in the world, your smartphone, computer, or tablet. Hopefully we'll be coming out.
Right here, we're moving the ball. Got a good drive going.
We'll face the Warriors next week. Tavius, nice carry and some. Breaks man, makes two tackles, makes a third miss. Holy cow! Ball comes out. No, that's down.
And I really, really thought he was down.
Me and you both. I believe the ground caused.
Yeah, I mean, he was just reaching out. And
of course, we went to the dressing room down big, Coach, and we'll pick up some highlights here in the second half. And, Coach, it was I don't have to remind you, but it was a 14-0 ball game with maybe 9 minutes or so to go in the second quarter when they scored to make it 21-0. And, of course, and then it was, 48-0 at half. So
right.
We gave up like five touchdowns there in the late or most of the second quarter for 2 weeks in a row. We're going to pick up New Albany with the football here and hopefully some positive things here we can watch on the highlights for the Braves here in a minute.
It's a fumble recovery for the Braves. Did he scoop and score? No, they're going to say he's down. I believe that's unsportsmanlike conduct looks to be the call here.
Took a while to sort this one out. What was going on here, Coach?
They ruled it a fumble, but then there was a personal foul against us, which backed us up. We did recover the ball.
So it is Braves football, and Coach, we had some inside the red zone a few times here and without getting any points. And
right.
This may have been one of those situations here.
Yeah, got Alex Cornelison in the at quarterback right now just to give him some reps just in case.
Well,
believe this is third down right here.
And we backed ourselves up, kind of put ourselves in a throwing down, and had Connor back in, tried to run the reverse.
And New Albany will take over on downs here on this particular series, but didn't take the Braves long to hold them, man. Coach, you had another really good defensive stand here and made them have to punt. Had a pretty good pressure on, and they get off a pretty good kick. But we still get great field position.
Yeah, right there at midfield.
Just got a little cooler down here.
This guy is capable of doing that just about every time
he
touches the ball.
You just give him a crease, he can hit the hole and get in the secondary quick.
I want to say he's close, maybe about the 2 yard line. So the Braves got the touchdown, but no extra point. We hold them again, and this time we're in the fourth quarter, so the Braves will get another opportunity right here. Doesn't get any better than this, Coach.
You are right. I hate he didn't get it into the end zone, but a great return.
Scared me when he fumbled it there.
Yeah.
But thank goodness the official was right there on the scene to we show this again. Keith, you used to do this when you played, right? I think he gave me a thumbs up. He's got a lot of white shirts after him, but and you think you've got a chance to get him, but he does like he did right there, split them, and that guy's trying to strip it out and did, but it was at the 1 yard line. So the Braves are going to get it on the one, first and goal. And that old flag comes out. Who's running the football there?
That's Carson Gaylor. We put that formation in a couple of weeks ago. Just a power formation. He's a big guy.
Carson got the fumble on the other one, didn't he? Didn't he get a fumble recovery on the
other one? I believe so.
Illegal participation.
Kind of caught my attention at practice. He'd get back there during kickoff coverage team, and he'd catch kickoffs and try to return them against our guys, and it looked pretty good at it, so I decided we may need to give this a try.
Coach, that's a good example right there of you do good in practice. Some of the coaches might see what you can do and get a chance. Well, the final score was 48-14. The teams congratulating each other, and we'll take her back in here. Once again, the Braves losing to the New Albany Bulldogs. And, of course, I don't know. Sometimes players have the attitude, not all of them, but every now and then, say, man, I get tired of practicing and all this stuff, whatever. Those practices, Coach, is how you get in the game, right?
That's right.
And if you don't practice well, you're probably not going to even get a chance to play well on Friday night. So, if you got somebody that's not giving effort in practice, their chances of getting on the field Friday night may not be quite as good, right?
That's right. You play like you practice, and unfortunately the past couple of weeks, I thought we've had good practices, but hadn't carried over on to Friday night.
But at least those guys that practiced hard was in the got the playing time, right?
Yes, sir.
Coach, we're going to look at Centertopia just a little bit before we wrap up our coaches show here in a little bit. Once again, I'm Jack Ivey and Coach Jim Mckay. And Coach, I want to remind you folks out there, we got a big road trip Friday night. This season winding down. What, two more games?
Two games.
Right? Two games. Got one on the road, and then Bahia will be coming to town on Friday. It'll be, the mamas don't want to hear this, but we're talking about a lot of tears tonight because it's senior night. The guys, last home game, and this is one of those years of the last if you're a senior. You know, this is the last senior party, the last first day of school. They got all kinds of last and whatever, but But Senatobia on the road Friday night, and hopefully you got us a good scouting report on Senatobia. They're going to be tough, though, right?
They are going to be tough. I compare them to the last three that we faced. A lot of speed, good up front, will be well coached. The last two teams that we play, well, last week, this week, Brooks Oakley at Senatobia does a really good job. His dad, Phil, was the head coach there for years. I got to know him when I was coaching at Oxford. Jake Hill, who was at New Albany, I coached under Johnny Hill at Oxford. So those two teams, well coached, good guys, you know, they'll have them ready, but hopefully we will too.
Of course, Friday, with it being a pretty gone wrong road trip, what's the schedule for Friday? Have you got it figured out yet?
We're leaving early.
Leaving early?
We are going to go through Holly Springs, stop and eat there. We're probably going to leave the school about 1 or 1:30.
Now, how will y'all go? Have you got it mapped out yet?
We will go down 72 through Holly Springs.
Cut over
through Independence to Senatobia.
Independence. Of course, Senatobia, I've got a lot of friends over there over the years, used to work with some of the guys up in the Memphis area and stuff, and one of them being a friend, old Jerry Stiegler over there, he's going to ask me, are y'all coming to the game Friday night? And I said, Jerry, we cover them all, and he was wondering if we covered the road games, and we've never done a season of anybody's football when we didn't do, you know, the whole season home and on the road. And you know, there may be still some of that out there. We'll talk about basketball for a second. There were some teams that used to broadcast. They would broadcast the boys and wouldn't broadcast the girls. And we've always, if we do a game, we're gonna do them, boys, girls. We're going to do the entire season. So we don't want to. Of course, around here, you know, the girls' basketball is pretty good. You'd be in trouble if you didn't do the girls,
too, right,
or whatever and stuff. But, Coach, this has been a tough season. I know the guys, you know, started out with Coach Leathers last year, ended the season. Then we had Coach Ray there, coached him for a few games, and he had a particular offense in, and we're not trying to make excuses for you, but we went back to the spread. You went back to the spread because you figured that might be our best opportunity to win. Is that?
Yeah, I feel like if you can get people out of the box, you have a better chance of running the football.
Spread the field a little bit.
Yeah, and it's what I know. I'm more familiar and comfortable with that style of offense and getting the kids in the positions to try and be successful. You know, and we've shown potential this year. Made some mistakes that I think we shouldn't have, but, you know, that's growing pains, and we'll learn and we'll get better.
Of course, you go back, and I guess it doesn't matter if it's our game or a college game or whatever, if you can cut down on the mistakes.
That's right.
You go back and look at what happened in the second quarter the last 2 weeks. You know, you take away all the turnovers, and you can say if, Jack, and whatever. But if you do take away all those, it's they're totally. We may not have come out on top, but you know, you probably don't lose 48-14
right,
either, or the other score and stuff. So, guys, I promise you, we're behind you, and we're going to be there, of course, Friday night, covering the Braves as they take on Senatobia. I promise you, the coaches are still working hard. You parents, stay in there and support the coaches and the players, and hopefully, Coach, we can get a big win over in Senatobia. So, Coach, we appreciate you driving down and doing the coaches show. I've been able to get Coach to buy me some breakfast, but he has to hurry around and get back to school, and we ain't even had a chance to do that, have we, Coach?
Not yet.
But, Coach, driving in that traffic, talking about the slow drivers out there and stuff, you may need a helmet with some of these early morning drivers, all these people trying to get to work at the last minute and stuff. Because you can tell if they're late, if they're passing you in curves and everything else and stuff. So, but we appreciate all you folks out there. I appreciate Coach Jim Mckay, the coaching staff, the players, fans, the band, the cheerleaders. Y'all get out and make some noise over in Senatobia Friday night. We're going to wrap it up here. Appreciate Keith on the controls. Coach Jim Mckay, of course, the head coach for the Tish County Braves on the Coaches Show. Don't forget you can watch the Coaches Show on our YouTube channel. Just go to YouTube.com and search Jack Ivy there and scroll down. Or you can punch in the Tish County Braves Football Coaches Show and you can watch it as well. We've got all the games on our YouTube channel as well. But you can watch these replays, of course, on Channel 97 many, many times, including Saturday night, also again on Tuesday night, we give you other opportunities to see it. So no reason to not be able to watch the replays because we'll give you a lot of opportunities. For the entire staff and management of WRMG-TV 12, TV 97, see you Friday night. Blake Long, and Randall Lindsay will be on the call. Riley Floyd will be there with a camera. And we got you right here on the Tishomingo County Braves Football Coaches Show. We'll see you next time.
You've been watching the Tishomingo County Braves Football Coaches Show with head coach Jim Mckay. Your host for the Tishomingo County Coaches Show has been Jack Ivey.